Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Can't hear Prabhu. Volume is very low. Yes.
Usha Mataji, you can hear me now?
Yeah. Can hear you, Prabhu. Thank you.
I can hear. Bhumika, Hare Krishna, you can hear me?
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Yes, Prabhu, I can hear you.
Good. Bhavagrahi, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Dhanu Pranam, Prabhu.
So we have the team now. People will keep joining as usual. People living near the railway station always miss the train. Next. That's right. Number 20. Demigod worship 20 to 25. Very beautiful shlokas. We can Hare Krishna Arvinda Angi Prabhu. He's the one you're telling me there. You are from Kasaragod, Prabhuji? Arvind Angri Prabhu?
Hare Krishna Prabhu, yes Prabhu.
Then Kasaragod has stabilized now? Now you're in Bahrain. Bahrain?
Yeah, I live in Bahrain, Prabhu, yeah.
So now Kasaragod, good news, has stabilized, hana?
It's getting better. My mother was saying, yeah, it's getting better now.
Yeah, there, whatever.
At least. Thank you for that.
Good. So, how's in Bahrain now with all the prices of oil and petrol down?
Yeah, petrol down and business is like down everywhere. It's almost partial, business is not there at all, because of the restrictions.
Correct. So, I think in India, from third week, they're starting operation gradually.
Yeah. So, trouble everywhere. Dukkalayam ashashvatam.
Yes. This goes on. In fact, Prabhupada was many times during some calamity like this, when there is some big disease or something, they went to Prabhupada. Prabhupada never got hyped up. Prabhupada says it's part of material nature. It's always dangerous here. Why we get a little surprised? Because we thought this world is a place to enjoy. So we get a little surprised. Oh, sickness. What is happening here? Never saw in my life things like this. But they thought, because everybody thought this world is a place for enjoyment. But that's Prabhupada true. Never saw like that. Even though people thought. He always thought had a very pathetic attitude toward this world. Prabhupada, the spiritual world means all good. Metal world, all bad. So just like, suppose some person, you have think he's a very nice person and behaves in a stupid way, you get upset. Correct? Why did he speak like this? But already where your mind is set up, he's a crazy man. If he speaks in a crazy way, I'd say no, he's a crazy man. Correct? The same way, metal nature, you already have a picture, Prabhupada, is a pathetic place. So when a disease like that, this is a pathetic place. Easy. But for some of us, you thought this is a wonderful place. It's a surprise. Never saw in my life, whole life. Most of the people are saying like that. Whole life. Yeah. I didn't say. Doctors are saying, I never saw so many patients,
Part.
Just like say, the America, there is 9/11. There was a big thing. 10,000 people died. Correct? There was a big, people were shocked. What happened? No. When you see such a news to an acharya, he's not alarmed or shocked. It's part of the nature. It's always like the world is a pathetic place. So once you resolve yourself now to the world is a pathetic place, because nothing is redundant in Krishna's kingdom. Nothing is redundant. Even this has a value. You understanding my point? There is some reason why for you such a pathetic situation is presented. All of us, just to get a hint, what is the miserable? If you get that, Krishna has done his job.
That's true.
Convinced us.
Probably yesterday I missed the talk class, bro. I was not, I was in the office.
Yesterday I went through many shlokas. In fact, I was reading the shloka just half an hour before the class, and I felt the purports are amazing. In the particularly 9th chapter, is such a beautiful chapter. So today, what we read, we will just, because this is a Devata worship area, let us read it. Even the purports are beautiful. Let us read them. Take care? Okay. All right. Generally, I just read the translations in this 3 o'clock class compared to the morning or night. Morning and night, we read word by word meaning, and we go to the word by word we study. But sometimes some areas are, even though this is summary study in the afternoon, it depends on all of us. We can do in a proper way.
Yeah.
There's no rule on us. We are free. Hare Krishna, Nishant.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Chalo. So we will do a little detail today. We do few shlokas instead of running through. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Agyanati Mirandasya Agyananjana Shalakaya Chakur Militam Yena Tasmay Shri Guruve Namah. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Krishnaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Saraswate Devi Gaudavani Pracharine Vishay Sivadi Vashat Deshatare Jayo Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda
Nityananda
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare
Hare Hare.
Okay, thank you, everybody. Let us start off. Trayvidya mama soma paha puta papa.
Trayvidya mama soma paha puta papa.
Rupa Mataji has come. Mataji, you say.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yeah. We will just set. You are going to chant the shlokas. And then who is going to read the translation? Any volunteer? Murthy Mataji, you read the translation.
Okay, Prabhu.
Who will read the purport? Baba, your signal is working, see? Hare Krishna, Bhavagrahi.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
See, signal is working. You said it is not working.
Yeah, sometimes it's working, sometimes. I'm coming terrace side, so it's working.
Take care. Arvindangi Prabhu, you will read the purport.
Okay, Prabhu. Okay, Prabhu.
Take care. Yeah, your signal looks strong. Okay. Chalo, Rupa Mataji, start.
Vaividya mam soma papoota papa yajneshva svargatim prathayante te punyam ashadya surendra lokam ashnanti divyan divideva bhogan.
Translation. Those who study the Vedas and drink the Soma Rasa, seeking the heavenly planets, worship me indirectly. They take birth on the planet of Indra, where they enjoy godly delights.
They take birth. Okay. Yes. Yes. Arvind Nange Prabhu. Today we'll read the purports. Yeah.
The word Trividya refers to the three Vedas, Sama, Yajur, and Rigveda. A Brahmana who has studied these three Vedas is called Trivedi. Anyone who is very much attached to knowledge derived from these three Vedas is respected in society. Unfortunately, there are many great scholars of the Vedas who do not know the ultimate purport of studying them. Therefore, Krishna herein declares himself to be the ultimate goal for Trivedis. Actual Trivedis take under the lotus feet of Krishna and engage in pure devotional service to satisfy the Lord. Devotional service begins with the chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra side by side, trying to understand Krishna in truth. Unfortunately, those who are simply official students of Vedas become more interested in offering sacrifices to the different demigods like Indra and Chandra. By such endeavor, the worshippers of different demigods are certainly purified of the contamination of the lower qualities of nature and thereby elevated to the higher planetary system or heavenly planets known as the Maharloka, Janarloka, Tapoloka, etc. Once situated on those higher planetary system, one can satisfy his senses hundreds of thousands of times better than on this planet.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Prabhuji. So Trivedi, I know I had a classmate with the name Trivedi, and asked the name of Trivedi, he didn't know. Again, that's the situation. Sam, Yajur, Rick. So if anybody knows these three, there is Ek Vedi, there is Dvivedi, Trivedi, and there are also Chaturvedi in India. Anna? So Trivedi means you know these three Vedas, but some today they don't know the meaning also of that. So Krishna is saying, I'm the ultimate goal. And this actually, the Trivedi is what they do. They want to drink, attaining heaven by piety, and they want to enjoy drinking Soma Rasa juice, go to heaven. So Prabhupada is now going into detail. He said, these are all misdirected people. Actual Trivedis take shelter of Krishna. So Krishna says, I am, worship me indirectly. But actually he is a real, if they're intelligent, worship directly. They take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna. And Prabhupada's very important thing. Devotion service begins with chanting Hare Krishna and side by side trying to understand Krishna in truth. So in a preaching, there's two things we have to do. One side we tell people, chant Hare Krishna. Other side, basic understanding of Krishna consciousness. How Krishna is the Supreme Lord, we are all His servant, Devata. This is two things have to go parallelly. What are the two things parallelly you have to do? One side make them chant Hare Krishna, some understanding of Krishna. These two things have to go side by side. Otherwise, you will tell him to chant Hare Krishna, he will cannot continue. He'll chant few days and stop. So, but with those who are official students of the Vedas, the Vedavada, Rata, they are called so many other names. They are more interested in all this, They are. That's what the Bhagavad Gita also, Traiguniya Vishya Veda, Nisraiguniya Bhava Arjuna, second chapter, Arjuna, rise above the Vedas. Because mostly people are attracted by the Karmakanda portion of the Vedas, all the Pushpitam, Yamimam Pushpitam Vacham, all the flowery words of the Vedas. There is a nice heavenly garden there, you can enjoy, like that. The different demigods certainly purify contamination, lower modes of nature. Okay, so when you worship devatas also, there is some purification. And there's satoguna, you will come gradually. And elevated to the higher planet system, heavenly planet, Maharloka, Janaloka. And once there, you can enjoy your senses 100,000 times better than on this planet. And people focus themselves on this. But we have to focus, what do you want? We want to go back to Krishna Loka, then we take shelter of a pure devotee and learn the process. Therefore, we should not be surprised that anything less than pure devotion, Prabhupada rejects. We should not be surprised. Correct? Prabhupada is on a target to give us something very special. Hare Krishna, Himali Mataji, welcome.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yes. So you want to go to heaven and drink Somarasa or you want to go to Vaikuntha?
You're asking me, Prabhu?
Yeah.
I want to go to Vaikuntha.
Well, what about Somarasa? Are you going to miss then?
Not needed, bro.
Not needed. There, anyway, Krishna will be better. Drink the Soma juice. Drink nectar of Krishna consciousness. Yes, Rupa Mataji. It's fine. This shloka is fine. See, the purport is very useful. Prabhupada has pinpointed purport with details. So let us not miss the purports now, as far as sometimes maybe. Chalo.
Tetam yes, Rupa. Yeah. Tetam bhukva swarga loka vishalam shine punya martya lokam vishanti evam trahi dharmam anuprapanna kathagatam kama kama labante.
When they have thus enjoyed heavenly sense pleasure, they return to this mortal planet again. Thus through the Vedic principles, they achieve only flickering happiness.
Yes, Arvind Angri Prabhu. Arvind Angri.
One who is promoted to those higher energy systems enjoy a longer duration of life and better facilities for sense enjoyment. Yet, one is not allowed to stay there forever. One is again sent back to this earthly planet upon finishing the resultant fruits of pious activities. He who has not attained perfection of knowledge, as indicated in Vedanta Sutra, Janmadi Asya Yattaha, or in other words, he who fails to understand Krishna, the cause of all causes, becomes baffled in achieving the ultimate goal of life and is thus subject to the routine of being promoted to the higher planets and then again coming down as if situated on the Ferris wheel, which sometimes goes up and sometimes comes down. The purport is that instead of being elevated to the spiritual world where there is no longer any possibility of coming down, one simply revolves in the cycle of birth and death on higher and lower planetary systems. One should better take to the spiritual world to enjoy eternal life full of bliss and knowledge and never return to this miserable material existence.
So nice. So you go to Deva Deva Loka, you want to drink Soma Rasa, but the problem is you enjoy, okay, heavenly sense pleasure. You see the apsaras dancing, drink Soma Rasa, and you're finding life is great, wonderful, but they achieve only flickering happiness. Gata Agatan, Kama Kamaha. Shine Punya Martha Lokam Vishanti. This has been said many times. See, just like you go to America. Now, America is like a better place for enjoyment for some people. Now, nobody has a plan to go to America. Even Americans in India don't want to go back to their country. You know that? There is a. India is saying those are American tourists who are stuck in India. We'll make arrangements. No, America, we don't want to go now. It is so dangerous, particularly the main city, New York, their main city. The same way, but generally, you know, they say place for enjoyment, everybody wants to go. But once you go as a tourist there, you have to come back after your money is finished. The same way, Devaloka, you go with Punya. And you're purchasing happiness by your Punya. So Punya is the real currency in this world for happiness. What is the real currency? Punya, not money. Just like you don't have money, but somebody will give you a car. If you have Punya, you will get cars still to enjoy. Even though you didn't have money. The real currency is punya, not cash. So when you have punya, therefore in Vedic culture, there are very, very, those who are karmakandi people, very keen to accumulate punya. You have some congregation people also, always punya. They're very excited for punya there somewhere. They want to accumulate punya, correct? But actually anyway, better than a Krishna conscious person is much better, but a normal man, better the person wants to accumulate punya, collect punya. So why? Because then you enjoy. Take care. And Papa, you suffer. But a devotee is not attracted to this Pushpatam Vacha. He is more attracted to go back to Krishna's lotus feet. So when the punya is over, this routine we promote to higher than coming down. Instead of being elevated to the spiritual world, there is no longer any possible one, simply a cycle of birth and death. So what to take to spiritual life and go back to Krishna. You want to switch it off? It's cool enough. Yeah, now it's cool. Don't spoil the little girl or addicted them. Okay. Chalo,
Anantayanto mam yejana paryupasate tesham nitya biyuktanam yokakshemam vahamyaham.
Translation. Those who worship me with devotion, meditating on my transcendental forms to them, I carry what they lack and preserve what they have.
One who is unable to live for a moment with but Krishna consciousness cannot but think of Krishna 24 hours, being engaged in devotional service by hearing, chanting, remembering, offering prayers, worshipping, serving the lotus feet of the Lord, rendering other services, cultivating friendship, and surrendering fully to the Lord. Such activities are all auspicious and full of spiritual potencies. Indeed, they make the devotees perfect in self-realization. Then, his only desire is to achieve the association of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is called Yoga. By the mercy of Lord, such devotee never comes back to this material condition of life. Kshema refers to the merciful protection of the Lord. The Lord helps the devotees to achieve Krishna consciousness by yoga when he becomes fully Krishna conscious. The Lord protects him from falling down to miserable conditioned life.
So now Krishna says, okay, you may be doing all those things, going on a ferris wheel up and down. But if you are intelligent, Krishna has said, ananyas chintayantoma, without any diversion, without any destruction, no other. There is no other ananya. He's constantly thinking about me. Ye jana paryupasate, you're worshipping me. For proper translate, paryupasate, properly you're worshipping me. Tesha, this is a very famous shloka. Nityabhi yuktanam yogakshimam vahameham. I carry what they have and I add what they need. I carry what they lack and preserve what they have. Okay? Hmm? Oh, for remembering?
Yeah.
That Patram Pushram is it. Every day, Patram Pushram? Everyone knows Patram Pushpam. Patram Pushpam, yaad hai? Nahin. Patram Pushpam, yaad hai? Nahin. Haan? Aadha yaad hai.
We'll give.
Do bol raha hai.
Aadha yaad hai.
Ananya Bhakta, complete protection. Reach there, 26. Let us see where we reach. Okay. Then if you don't reach, then this is a shloka. Ananya Chintayanto Mam, this is a very famous shloka, Yogapka. You know the famous story behind the shloka?
That Brahmana story, bro.
What is the story?
Hello?
Yeah, what is the story? Yamunacharya story.
Yamunacharya.
Yeah, you know the story? Krishna Balaram. Yes, bro. Tell.
there was a Brahmana who was running the Gurukul, he was having many students in Gurukul, but he had no income at all. So he was just every day someone will bring for the prasadam, and you know, somehow he was able to feed students or kids. So one day it happened like no one brought anything, and Brahmana's wife was worried like how to make the prasadam for the kids. It was already noon time, and she was coming and asking him, you know, how to cook. There's nothing to cook. Then Brahmana said, no, Lord will arrange somehow. But then it was too late, and somehow Brahmana also, you know, got a doubt, and then he went out and get something. But before that, I think if I remember correctly, he read this shloka like ananyam chintayanto mam yajana paripasate tesham nityam yuktam yogakshemam vahamyaham. And what he did is like, it's not necessary that Lord will come and he will take care of things. Maybe he will make he changed. If I remember, it's like he said, like instead of vahami aham, he said karomi something. He did. He changed that. He struck the shloka, and then he went out, but he didn't get anything. But before that, he used the red ink and struck the last part of the shloka. And two boys, they came to Brahmana's house carrying loads of grain and food materials. And they were very tired. So the Brahmanas' wife asked them, "Who are you?" Like they said, "We are disciples of your husband." And when they were, she could notice beating muck on one of the boys' back. Then she asked, "What happened to you?" Then we were late, so your husband beat us with the stick. That's why we got this. And she got very angry, and she asked them to sit inside the house, cook for you prasadam. But by the time the Brahmana came, she was very furious. She didn't want to talk to him. She said, I never thought you are such a cruel person, because you beat your students." And he was like confused. He asked, "What happened? Explain to me." Then she told, "You beat your students for, they were late." Then, "Where are they?" he asked. They said, "Like, they are inside the house." So when they went to see him, see those boys, they were not there. So then the Brahmana realized, this was the Lord, Krishna Balaram, who came. So then I think he went back to the sloka and saw that that mark was not there. Something like that. Sorry, maybe it's not the proper, but the story, I thought.
Yeah, that's okay, the story. Only the personality is not ordinary. He's Yamunacharya.
Yamunacharya.
Yeah. This is a guru of Ramanujacharya. He was writing actually the commentary on Gita. And when he saw that aham, bahami, aham, he got a surprise. Why Krishna will come and deliver? He will arrange, no? He will send somebody to make an arrangement. Why will Krishna will come? So he cut that. So that was the beating marks on the Krishna's back. Krishna feels pain when he changes words. Okay? That is signifying the the beating on the back was Krishna showed, or the pain he feels that somebody changes his word. Krishna doesn't like anybody to. When Krishna has said aham means aham, he will do it. Correct? Krishna is there in the heart of the Paramatma, everybody, he will take care of it. Yoga, kshema. There are two words very important. Yoga means our connection to the Lord, our approach towards Krishna, and kshema means Lord's merciful protection. So this is the important point. Otherwise, Prabhuji, your story is perfect. And he went to take bath after that. And when he came back, things were already arranged. Things had already come. All the grocery items he didn't have was already there in the house. Wife had cooked. And wife was, what he said, perfectly. She was very upset with him, that why he has behaved so badly. What happened, Yamunacharya? Nowadays, you are, getting angry. You beat up people also, I heard. Like that, she started when he came back, and finally, there was a pleasant surprise. Okay, is it fine? But it's not for everybody. This is for Ananyas Chintaya. So you do Ananyas Chintaya, then don't worry. We have many examples in the history. Prabhupada says all you need to do is think about Krishna all the time. Prahlad Maharaj, everything will be taken care of. But we don't have faith. We don't have that kind of faith. That's like Prabhupada used to say, you just see to it that you're preaching Krishna consciousness, Krishna will take care of maintaining you. We don't have that faith. We need that faith. He'll give intelligence then, definitely. Hare Krishna, we have some new person here. Naveen, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Naveen.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
You introduce yourself.
I just keep receiving messages, Prabhu. So I just thought today, let me join in into the...
Okay. You, where are you staying? Which place?
I stay at Kodialbari.
Oh, you are in Mangalore?
Yeah.
Oh, welcome.
I'm Gautam's friend, Prabhu.
Huh?
Gautam's friend.
Oh, the tall person. I met you sometime.
Yes, exactly.
Sometimes I met you here and there. Correct. You had come on a yatra once with us.
Yes.
Srirangam, Rameshwaram.
Yes. Srirangam.
Now we remember you. Good. So good. Welcome. Naveen, this we start at 3:00. You are welcome anyway. We are in the middle now.
I was on a Zoom meeting with the official work, so just to conclude.
No problem. Anytime you can join. You can join later also. I have no problem. So I was doing now, what we have been reading through the Gita in this, and say this is our Gita study program at 3:00. Okay. Also have in the night 9:00. That is little difficult. Chaitanya Charitamrita, that's for people who are serious chanting. And in the morning, 6:00, we have also another Gita one. Okay. So sometime, whichever is convenient, you can join. You can join morning 6 is a very pleasant time. And you will be free from all office work that time. Okay. But you have to get up by the alarm clock. You have to get up and be ready.
Yes.
Take care. Welcome. Welcome, Navi.
Hare
Krishna. So this, so we are not discussing some shlokas from the 9th chapter of Bhagavad Gita today. We are just going shloka after shloka, reading the shlokas, explanation and discussing. Okay. And other people are Pusha Mataji is in Bangalore, Arvind Nangir Prabhu is in Bahrain, Bhavagrai is in Calcutta, Bhumika is in Modibidri, Himali is in Varanasi, Nishant is in Estonia. Nishant? Yeah, and Rupa Mataji is also in Bahrain. Sushmita is in Surat. And Vanita is in Karwa. Belthangadi, Belthangadi. No, Belthangadi is her house. She's at the parents' house now. She is in Kundapura. Okay, so. So Ananya Chinta Yanto Maam, so this discussion is going on. Ananya, without any diversion thinking about Krishna, and they worship Krishna in this way, Krishna, what he does? Nityabhi Yuktana. He takes, maintains them, and if something they lack, Krishna provides. So what all we need to do is that we need to be sincere. Ananya. Ananya bhakti is needed. There is no distraction. Focused. Correct? Now we are spending time reading Bhagavad Gita. At the same time, Naveen could have done some business. Correct, Naveen? And you will think, I lost something. Don't worry, you'll not lose. Don't have to worry. Krishna will compensate for that. Okay? That's the point. So, this Ananya Bhakti is not easy. Cannot but think of Krishna 24 hours by the Navavidha Bhakti. Okay. Let us go to the next shloka. Any question or till now on the shloka 22nd we discussed?
Just one thing I want to know.
Hmm. Yes, Mataji.
See, this last para, Vahami Aham. See, Yamunacharya, what mistake he did when writing this, Vahami Aham?
No, no, he said not Krishna. Something said he translated the not Krishna will not come and supply personally. He will arrange, he will send somebody, he will tell, you know, Indra or somebody to do it. He will not come. Supreme Lord Narayana, he will do all this thing. He will take care personally to arrange for you. Correct? You got it?
Okay.
He will not get personally involved in the whole thing. You know, some Devi Devata will tell, oh, just take care. Huh? Therefore, Krishna Balaram personally came to the house of Yamunacharya. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, is it fine? Yes, Rupa Mataji, continue.
Devata Bhakta Yajante Shatayanvita. Te api mam eva kaunteya yajanti abhiti purvaka.
Whatever a man may sacrifice to other gods, O son of Kunti, is really meant for me alone. But it is offered without the true understanding.
Purport. Persons who are engaged in the worship of demigods are not very intelligent. Although such worship is done to meet indirectly. Krishna, if, for example, when a man pours water on the leaves and branches of a tree without pouring water on the root, he does so without sufficient knowledge or without observing regulatory principles. Similarly, the process of rendering service to different parts of the body is to supply food to the stomach. The demigods are, so to speak, different officers and directors in the government of the Supreme Lord. One has to follow the laws made by the government, not by the officers or directors. Similarly, everyone is to offer his worship to the Supreme Lord only. That will automatically satisfy the different officers and directors of the Lord. The officers and directors are engaged as representative of the government, and to offer some bribe to the officers and directors is illegal. This is stated here as Purvakam. In other words, Krishna does not approve the unnecessary worship of the
demigods. It's not intelligent. Avidhi Purvakam, you know, generally Prabhupada gives a very nice body and the tree. Then if you want to satisfy the devatas, there is no limit. the crores of devatas. It is exactly like taking a syringe and putting water in every leaf of a tree. It's not practical. Correct? One devata is satisfied, other is angry. Usko satisfied that. There are millions of devatas. Better put water on the root, it goes automatically. What is the shloka? Yatataror mulani shechanena tepyanti satskanda bhujapishakam prana upahara chaitindriyanam tathaiva sarva aranam achyutecha. Yad the shloka? Yatataror mulani shechanena. Taro means a tree. You put water on the root of the tree. Taror mulani shechanena. If you put water in the root of the tree, automatically the water goes to all the bhuja, all the branches, upashaka, sub-branches, everywhere it goes. So same way you put food in the stomach, automatically the whole body gets energy. You don't have to take a syringe and put water in every cell in the body. No, just eat, it goes. So the vidhi, avidhi purvaka means it's a wrong way. To think that I will satisfy one by one devata, that society generally does. No. You worship Krishna. Automatically, everybody is taken care of. You don't have to separately worship all the devata. Therefore, Krishna is saying, without true understanding, people do all this thing. Okay? Indirectly, yes, devi devata worship, but it's not Krishna saying, not recommended, unnecessary worship. Okay? Officer, director, another thing Prabhupada said is like giving bribe. Why you want to bribe? They go to the Devi Devata, please, 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 I will give you 2 coconut, 5 coconut, get me this done, please, please. Dhanam Dehi, Putaram Dehi, 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 give, give, give. And there is Ganesha Mantra also, right? So many mantras people chant, get me, get me. Prabhupada says it's just like giving bribe. Because Krishna already knows your problem, why are you doing all this thing? True, the system is, you will get also from the Devatas, but then it comes without any protection. Because it will not be good for you. Krishna is in your heart. He knows what you want. If Krishna is not giving something to you, leave it, no. But no, we go to Devi Devatas, break our head, get me, get me. You're able to understand, Naveen? Hare Krishna, Naveen, you are with us?
Yes, Prabhu, I'm there.
Take care. This is a little delicate topic in India, worship of Hari and worship of Devatas. But generally in the society, the worship of Hari and worship of Devatas is a mess. You see, every puja room will have all the pictures. They have Krishna pictures, not they don't have. They have Rama picture also. But they will have everybody else also. Correct? And they really don't know who is God. You know, okay, these are all, mostly the idea is confusion. Who is God? What is God? Isn't it true?
Yes,
it's true.
And that is standard Hinduism, huh?
Each day of the week.
Yeah.
Each day of the week is someone.
Yeah, each day of the week. Today is Saraswati's day. Today is Ganesha's day. Today is Shiva's day. Hana. And every day, the temple you can go, you get free prasad. I don't know what they are doing now, temples. Kadri temple is still distributing daily free prasad. Closed, no? All temples are closed, no? No. Government order, all the gates are closed. Huh? You went and saw? What is happening, Naveen? All temples' gates are closed now?
Yeah, all temple gates are closed.
Even Venkatrana temple closed?
They're closed since March 23rd or 24th.
Okay, same time. Inside the puja is going on, but no visitors are allowed. Hana?
No visitors are allowed. And entire the three pujas of the day happen only in the morning and they finish it off.
Oh, and they close it after that.
Yeah.
Okay. We are doing our puja, everything in the temple. No problem. Because they don't stay there. Here we are staying.
Maybe. Yeah, here they do not stay there. So they finish it off. Correct. And after that, they are not allowed to come here.
But Mangalore has been lucky till now. Anna, we have been lucky. Correct?
Yes.
Not much infection in Mangalore till now. Anna?
The flights were stopped.
Yeah, flights. No, till now, Mangalore has been lucky. Let us see how it proceeds. Chalo, 24th shloka, Rupa Mataji.
Aham hi sarva yajnanam bhokta cha prabhureva cha natu mam abhijananti tatvena tascavantite.
Translate. I am the only enjoyer and the only object of sacrifice. Those who do not recognize
my true transcendental nature falls down.
Here it is clearly stated that there are many types of yajna performances recommended in the Vedic literatures, but actually all of them are meant for satisfying the Supreme Lord. Yajna means Vishnu. In the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita, it is clearly stated that one should only work for satisfying yajnas or Vishnu. The perfectional form of human civilization known as Varnashrama Dharma is specifically meant for satisfying Vishnu. Therefore, Krishna says in this verse, I am the enjoyer of all sacrifices because I am the Supreme Master. However, less intelligent persons, without knowing this fact, worship demigods for benefit. Therefore, they fall down to material existence and do not achieve the desired goal of life. However, anyone has any material desire to be fulfilled, he had better pray for it to the Supreme Lord, although that is not pure devotion, and he will thus achieve the desired result.
So no need to ask anybody, just ask Krishna if you have something to ask. But in an advanced platform, we don't ask Krishna for anything. We just want to please Krishna. That's not a platform of a devotee. Just like Hanuman doesn't go to Lord Rama with some list. He just sees what Lord Rama wants, not what he wants. Correct? Prabhupada says we should be accustomed to this, to get happiness by seeing Krishna happy. But not that Krishna, we use Krishna for our pleasures. We have to become order carrier of the Lord, not giving orders to Krishna. My dear Lord Krishna, there's a list. Get me this. You want to do that kind of servant you want to be, or go to the Lord Krishna? Krishna, please give your list, what you want to be done. So that's a difference. But generally, we give a list to the Lord, isn't it, Naveen? Like a ration, when you go to buy ration, you give
yes.
a list. Huh? And you go yes. to buy ration every month, what happens? You send a list. This. And it supplies. So we think Krishna is also like that only. Our order carrier. He's not our order. He's master. We should rather go and, my Lord, reveal to me what you want me to do. I like to serve you. That's beautiful. That's beautiful consciousness. So, but anyway, we should not ask the Lord. But if you ask, but go to Krishna. Don't go to Devi Devata. That is the whole essence here. I'm the only enjoyer and the only object of sacrifice. And if you do not do that, Krishna says you will fall down one day. Yajna means Vishnu. Chalo, it's very nice actually. These shlokas are clarifying step by step. Very, very important confusion of the society. And we are directly reading the Bhagavad Gita. Simple. Yes, Mataji.
Yanti Deva Vrata Devan Pitrun Yanti Pitru Vrata Bhutani Yanti Bhuteja Yanti Madhyaji Imam.
Translation. Those who worship the demigods will take birth among the demigods. Those who worship ghosts and spirits will take birth among the such beings. Those who worship ancestors go to the ancestors, and those who worship me will live with me.
Purport. If anyone has any desire to go to the moon, the sun, or any other planet, one can attain the desired destination by following specific Vedic principles recommended for that purpose. These are vividly described in the fruitive activities portion of the Vedas, technically known as Darsha Purnamasi, which recommends a specific worship of demigods situated on different heavenly planets. Similarly, one can attain the Pita planets by performing specific yajna. Similarly, one can go to many ghostly planets and become the Yaksha or Raksha or Pishacha. Pishacha worship is called black arts or black magic. There are many men who practice this black art and they think that it is the spiritualism, but such activities are completely materialistic. Similarly, a pure devotee who worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead only achieves the planet of Vaikuntha and Krishna Loka without a doubt. it is very easy to understand through this important verse that if by simply worshipping the demigods one can achieve the heavenly planets, or by worshipping the Pitta achieve the Pitta planets, or by practicing the black arts achieve the ghostly planets, why can the pure devotee not achieve the planets of Krishna or Vishnu? Unfortunately, many people have no information of this, of these sublime planets where Krishna and Vishnu live, and because they do not know of them, they fall down. Even the impersonalists fall down from Brahma Jyoti. This Krishna conscious movement is therefore distributing sublime information to the entire human society, to the effect that by simply chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, one can become perfect in this life and go back home, back to Godhead. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhupada. So, beautiful purport, clear to the point. Those who worship the Devatas, it's the Yanti Deva Vrata Devan. So, you take ticket for Calcutta, you will not go to Chennai. You'll go to Calcutta, correct? Or so, anyway, at least Calcutta you go via Chennai. So, let me take a better example. You go to Bombay and you go to Trivandrum. You take a ticket to Bombay, by that you cannot go to Trivandrum. Anyway, now the trains are not moving whenever it moves. Hmm? So the point is that it's not that many people say, I worship anything I do, yatomat tatopat, whatever I feel I worship, I get the same result. No, sir. Devatas are existing. It's not imaginary. Devatas have their planets also. And Krishna is also existing and he has a spiritual world to go. This world is like a jail. And the Devi Devatas are the predominating officers of this jail. Correct? So they have their place and it's a much more comfortable place. Just like in your prison, maybe, you know, some officer has a good chamber, it's AC. You can get some facilities there. Correct? And you maybe not have to break the stones. If you maybe if you satisfy a basic some in a jail, some officer, he will give you some job in his office. You just have to type some letters. Simple job, correct? Otherwise, you have to break stones. But instead of thinking of going from A class jail to B class jail to C class jail, why don't you get out of the jail? That's intelligent. But people are not that much intelligent. Yanti Deva Prata Devan, you get at the position. Pitri Yanti Pitri Vataha, you worship the ancestors, provided they are qualified. They will be there in Pitru Loka. Pitru Loka is another place where Yamaraj resides. Okay? And he there is in a pleasant mood. And he's in a comes of punishment, he's in a ferocious form. Bhutani Yanti Bhutejya, Mangalore people are expert. Not only Mangalore, actually, all the state people, Kerala, they're expert in Bhuta worship. As if I thought only Mangalore people are expert. Bengal, Odisha, they're also expert. When devotee had come, they said they give Bhuta on rent. Who is yeah, Sushmata? In Bengal, you give for rent, I heard. Bhutas. Hmm?
I never heard from
you know, monthly rent they give you. They catch the Bhutas and they give for rent and they do work for you. Bhuta will, you know. They're basically in Mangalore, what the principle they use Bhutas for, you know, protecting their farm, same thing.
Oh, like same thing. Not cooking.
But they do some work. In the night, you have to give them work. They are very restless. Like some people are also in India, in every city, they put like Bhutas. You leave them without work, they become restless. You have to give them some work. Huh? Bhuta means tamasic, a very disturbed person. Anyway, you're not interested in Bhuta, no? But one thing is there, you talk about Bhutas, they appear in that place. They say three people appear in a place when you're talking about them. One is snake, one is Bhuta, one is a politician. This is said by some saying is there. So, because snake somehow can make out, we are thinking. When you're thinking about snake, he appears in that place. And Bhuta, because he knows, he actually Bhutas are all around. Hey, they're talking about us and they come. They don't have a gross body. Bhuta means he doesn't have a gross body. Subtle body he has. And he's disturbed because he sees you with a facility that he doesn't have. Just like you're driving car. And Bhuta is somebody without car walking on the road, poor fellow. So he feels always envious. Sometimes Bhuta says, the car is slow, open the door and jump in. That is called haunting. Therefore, you should lock the door from inside. Okay, so, but Hare if you
Prabhu,
worship...
Prabhuji, I have a question on that.
Some Bhutapath you're having?
No, not Bhutapath. In Bangalore area, there is a form of worship. It's not actually, not talking about the Pretas. It's a way of worship. They worship like Vishnu in that Deva form. Deva Radhana, they call him, basically. You know, they have a lot of things going on. It's very difficult to convince like those people to get
Bhutganas. Whatever you do, all the community there, they worship Bhuta. As much as
you
can. Huh? What is that? Varaha.
Yeah, Varaha. Yeah.
They worship Varaha Deva. Anyway, I'm not, we have to really analyze it because
what they say is this was before Vedic culture came to this South India. They used to do like this Naga Radhane and Bhuta Radhane. Then slowly the Vedic princes, society came and they established temple worship, deity worship. So before that, they used to worship like Vishnu. They used to worship a Vishnu Murti form, like Varaha form. But it was like a different, like it's not a deity worship. So still, this is very popular in Bangalore.
Oh, wow. Popular means they do only that. What you're telling popular. If there is a Bhuta Arana, people all whole night they do night out. And here yes, exactly. Request to come for 1 hour to the temple, they will not come. They're really dedicated
all
to
this.
The Prabhu.
Kola.
Kola, yes.
Prabhu?
All experts are in now. Bhumika, yes.
Yes, and talking about that Daiva, that what they said, they call them as servants of God. They don't have specific this thing. They say servants of God.
Okay. Hello.
Like that. God... They don't see them as God. They call them servants of God.
Yeah, Bhuta Ganas. No, they are all servants of Lord Shiva. Generally.
Yes, Prabhu. Yes, Prabhu.
Shiva.
All the Bhutas Ganas.
Yeah, he the Bhuta Nata. And they say we have selected only top Bhutas, not ordinary Bhutas. Okay. Anyway, so as per the shloka here concerned, Bhutani Yanti Bhutecha. You worship ghost, you'll become ghost. Okay? But what kind of worship this is, I'm not an expert, so we'll have to ask some Panditji to clarify. Okay? As far as Gita is concerned, it's not recommended. Okay? Why not worship Krishna? What is the need of doing this Bhuta Gana Puja? Why not worship directly Krishna? Correct? There is no need. So if you worship Devatas, you go to their planet, you worship ancestry, you go to their planet, you worship Bhutas, you become another Bhuta. That's what he said. Okay, so now you justify, you actually, onus of justification is not on us, it is on the Bhuta Gana Puja. They have to justify. What do you say? For us, it is simple. Huh? Yes, sir. Simple shloka. Devata ki puja karo, dev ban jaoge. एंसेस्टर्स के पूजा करोगे वहां चले जाओगे पितृलोक में भूतों की पूजा करोगे भूत बन जाओगे एंड जो कृष्ण की पूजा करेंगे वैकुंठ लोक जाएंगे है ना वी हैव नॉट एक्चुअली सी व्हेन वी गॉट अ फर्म बोट वी आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन अदर बोट एज फार एज वी आर कंसर्न वी गॉट अ फर्म बोट चैंट हरे कृष्णा रीड भगवद गीता फॉलो द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस गिवन बाय कृष्णा गो बैक टू कृष्ण लोका करेक्ट दैट्स आवर बोट एंड द बोट इज सॉलिड Now they are saying we do the Bhuta Puja. Now you work it out. You justify that. But Gita is not recommending such a thing. Okay. Generally, actually, not only here, everywhere, actually, Devi Devata Puja is generally more prominent than direct worship of Vishnu because people are materialistic. They are not interested in spiritual. See, the worship of Devata is for materialistic people and worship of Krishna is for spiritual people. People are not interested in spiritualism. Generally, they are interested in materialism. So this will go on. See, many times people debate. I ask at the end one question to them. What the end of it, what do you want? If you want to go to Vaikuntha Loka to achieve a life free from anxiety and eternally, the point is eternally you want to live with Krishna without any cycle of birth and death, then only thing is to worship Krishna. Nothing else will work. Correct? But if you want to live in this world and attain a pleasant life, then it's... There are so many worships in this world going on, correct? So you have to study. Then you have to study.
what they do in Aradhana, finally, they have Prashna, they ask, you know? So many things that go on. We have to analyze where it, which component it is spiritual. And we saw Krishna just said a few shlokas before, avidhi purvakam. If you are through the devatas trying to worship me, it is avidhi purvakam. It is not proper vidhi. Correct? Even worship of the devatas, Shaligram Shila is always there. So when you're worshipping Devi also, you have to, the Yagneshwara Shaligram, that is always there. So that is still called the worship of the devata. Anna? So why we need to do that when we can directly worship Krishna? Okay. So anyway, we have simple. The shloka for us is encouraging to worship directly Krishna. Okay, there are many practices, black art, very popular. Just wanted to have some fun, actually, therefore I opened the Bhuta thing, but it is unending. People are very attracted. Bhuta on rent. Similarly, pure devotee worship the Supreme Personality, got it. Only the, achieve the planet of Vaikuntha Loka, Krishna Loka, without a doubt. So if you can worship Devi Devata and go to their planet, why not by worshipping Krishna, you go to his planet? But the difference is that Krishna's planet is Vaikuntha, Vaikuntha Loka. This whole world is a jail. Outside is Vaikuntha. Jail is very small. Vaikuntha is main thing. Take care. Don't think Vaikuntha is one more planet. No. Devi Devata's planets are within the jail. Within the compass, the middle world. Therefore, it is not very important to go there. It is very easy to understand. Take care. Why can't the pure devotee achieve the planet of Krishna Vishnu? Unfortunately, many people have no information to supply. They have no information. They are very happy to stay in the middle world. So therefore, Prabhupada is saying, this Krishna conscious movement, that the message of Bhagavad Gita, is giving a sublime information to the entire human society that by simply chanting the Krishna Nama, correct? All the acharyas encourage chanting on the name of the Lord. Madhvacharya said, Kalau Nama Matrena Pujade Bhagavan Hari. In Kaluga, Hari can you worship just by chanting his names. We chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Just chanting the Hare Krishna Mantra. And what happens just by doing that? One can become perfect in this life and go back home, back to God. Okay. Is it fine, everybody? Now, any question? Yes, so, the sublime information you take, the last blue lines, always blue lines are used for the most important point. Red is a warning. Blue and yellow and green are like important. Okay, is it fine? So we're getting a sublime information. So why not chant?
Okay, bro.
Yes, Bhumika. You still want to do Bhuta Aradhana?
No, Prabhu.
No, you will be socially forced to go sometimes. That's okay. But you cannot, you say, I don't go, then father, mother will be very upset and angry. Correct? Anna? What do you say? But better directly worship Krishna than indirectly. Okay, this is amazing shloka. Maybe the last shloka of the day today. Patram pushvam phalam toyam. Yeah. Rupa Madhade, sorry, yours. Yeah.
Patram pushvam phalam toyam. Yomi patra prayachati. Tadaham bhakti upam asnami pratatmanah.
Translation. If one offers me with love and devotion a leaf, a flower, fruit, or water, I'll accept it.
Perfect. Here, Lord Krishna, having established that he is the only enjoyer, the primeval Lord, the real object of all sacrificial offering, reveals what types of sacrifices he desires to be offered. If one wishes to engage in devotional service to Supreme in order to be purified and to reach the goal of life, the transcendental loving service of God, then he should find out what the Lord desires of him. One who loves Krishna will give him whatever he wants, and he avoids offering anything which is undesirable or unasked for. Thus, meat, fish, and egg should not be offered to Krishna. If he desired such things as offering, he would have said so. Instead, he clearly requires that a leaf, fruit, flower, and water be given to him. And he says of this offering, I will accept it. Therefore, we should understand that he will not accept meat, fish, eggs. Vegetables, grains, fruits, milk, and water are the proper food for human beings and are prescribed by Lord Krishna himself. Whatever else we eat cannot be offered to him, since he will not accept it. Thus, we cannot be acting on the level of loving devotion if we offer such foods. In the third chapter, verse 13, Sri Krishna explains that only the remains of sacrifice are purified and fit for consumption by those who are seeking advancement in life and release from the clutches of the material entanglement. Those who do not make an offering of their food, he says in the same verse, are said to be eating only sin. In other words, their every mouthful is simply deepening their involvement in the complexities of material nature. But preparing rice, simple vegetable dishes, offering them before the pitcher or deity of Lord Krishna, and bowing down and praying for him to accept such humble offering, enable one to advance steadily in life, to purify the body, and to create fine brain tissues, which will lead to clear thinking. Above all, the offering should be made with an attitude of love. Krishna has no need of food, since he already possesses everything that we ate. He will accept the offering of one who desires to please him in that way. The important element in preparation, in serving, and in offering is to act with love for Krishna. The impersonalist philosophers who wish to maintain their absolute truth is without senses cannot comprehend this verse of Bhagavad Gita. So for them, it is either a metaphor or proud proof of mundane character of Krishna, the speaker of the Gita. But in actuality, Krishna, Supreme Godhead, has senses, and it is stated that his senses are interchangeable. In other words, one sense can perform the functions of any other. This is what it means to say that Krishna is absolute. Lacking senses, he could hardly be considered full in all opulences. In the seventh chapter, Krishna has explained that he impregnates the living entities into material nature. This is done by his looking upon material nature. And so in this instance, Krishna, hearing the devotee's words of love in offering foodstuff, is wholly identical with their eating and actually tasting. This point should be emphasized because of his absolute position. His hearing is wholly identical with his eating and tasting. Only the devotee who accepts Krishna as he described himself without interpretation can understand that the Supreme Absolute Truth can eat food and enjoy it. Hare Krishna.
Okay. Krishna eats food and enjoys. The deity also has a tongue. We forget that. Correct? He also enjoys. So this is a very important point. Take care. This is Prayata Atmanaha Bhakti Upaharitam Bhaktya. So there are three times these words are there. Bhaktya, with devotion. Bhakti Upaharitam, offered in devotion. And Prayata Atmanaha, of one in pure consciousness. So prasadam has three components. You have to cook with devotion. You have to offer with devotion. And then you have to eat with devotion. Correct? Then it has an effect. You don't cook in devotion. You don't offer in devotion. You don't honor with devotion. Enough? That will not be effective. Then it will maybe sanctified food. But it's not have... See, everything has a variety. It's like there is Radharani is also the ultimate devotee of Krishna. We also call ourselves devotees, correct? But we know there is a heaven and earth difference. Similarly, prasadam also is absolute always, but when it is done with devotion. Yes, Murthy Mataji, you understand this point?
Yes, Prabhu.
When you cook with great devotion, offer with great love, and respectfully honor it, it will be very, very powerful. just like chanting. When you chant with great attention, it is much more powerful. Then you just do Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Correct? Everywhere has Nama Parada and Shuddha Nama. So Prasadam also can be Prasada Parada and Shuddha Prasadam. You know, it'll be powerful, very, very effective. Anyway, this is so here coming to the main point of the shloka, Patra is the leaves, Pushpa is the flowers, Phala is fruits, and Toyam, water. Okay? Toyam is water. So you can only offer these things. Krishna restricted a vegetarian diet. Not only for himself, even for you. Because Krishna said in the previous chapter, if you eat something which you are not offered to me, you are eating goblets of sin. What is the shloka? Yes, yeah, Sridhara, what is the shloka? Yagna Shishta Shino Santo Munchyante Sarva Kilvishai Bhunjata Deitu Agam Papam Ye Pachanti Atma Karana. For your own sake, when you cook and eat, actually you are eating goblets of sin. Therefore, previously in the Vedic time, there will be no hotels in a city. Nobody will eat in a hotel. At home, they will eat, do Nevedya and eat, or they go to some temple. In fact, the same situation we also practice in ISKCON. When we travel to any city, first we look for a temple. We go eat in a temple. We don't eat outside, correct? As a practice, we avoid. True, yeah. For some time, then we have to take curd and rice and somehow manage. But this is how it is, okay? So, Patra, Pushpa, Phalam, Toyam. So, never eat. Actually, as a principle, as you become serious in spiritual life, eat only prasadam. The best. If you can come to the standard, that is the best. Because food is not carrying any karma. Because then vegetarian food has some karma. Correct? You have given incarnations to the plant. Udhar mein bhi kuch karma. Aur khana pakate samay to kuch bacteria mare the. Udhar bhi karma aaya, hai na? But when you take food, which is offered to the Lord, Krishna takes the karma. And he gives you his mercy. There is, the food is spiritualized. To say, strictly speaking, it is mixed with Krishna's saliva. Therefore, prasadam is very, very different. The normal food, correct? They're different. Patram, Pushpam, Phalam, Toyam, Yo, Bhakta, Prajita. So Krishna says, when you give it devotion, Tadham, Bhakti, again Bhakti. See, Bhakti, Bhakti and Prayatatmana, three times it's emphasized. From a person who is pure consciousness. Krishna is not hungry, Prabhupada says, of your food. He is not hungry. He is fully self-satisfied. But when you offer his love, he accepts. Just like at home, you go as a father, a small child offers you the toffee, you accept it. It is from your own money, but you accept his love. So what is Krishna accepting? Your love. Hai na? Krishna, I made chhappan bhoga, aapko to khana hi padega. You cannot force it. Hai na? You have to eat. I made 56, I not eat. What you will do? You cannot force him. Very important point. So let us go to the shloka. He's the only enjoyer, he said in the previous shloka, and he said now what to sacrifice to. Okay? What time to sacrifice the desires to be offered? So if you want to please the Lord, you should know what he wants. Just like, suppose you are not feeling hot. You want lemon juice. Somebody gives you hot milk. Now would you like it? Garmi mein, no. So you should, no, you should take. Are, why you should take care? I don't want it. So we should be clear. And then Prabhupada has forbidden this non-veg item. These are all. See, all this corona problem has been because of not following Krishna's instruction. Bhagavad Gita has a solution to all the problems. Anna? What is Krishna's instruction? Patram, Pushpam, Phalam, Toyam. Why don't you go and tell the Chinese people? Again, they opened the market. They open now. And again, another one will come. This they got from bat, probably.
Pangolins.
Huh?
Pangolins.
From pangolins, they got this virus. They saw this virus lying in Indian bats also yesterday.
There is nothing called as Indian bats. They keep migrating.
Migrating here and there. But they found in India also bats having. So not one. Just imagine one. There are how many are there? Ebola, there are another one which is not spread. There are so many are there which are
Nipah.
Viruses.
Nipah also. Huh?
Nipah. Nipah. So many are there. So Krishna is telling, you don't eat that. I have put all the viruses there. You eat flowers. Fruits, you'll not get anything because how you eat them, you cook and eat, you know. And not only that, even the animal they eat and not eaten without cooking. Otherwise, how they got the virus? Isn't it? Which your fellow got it. He must have done something.
He clearly requires that a leaf, fruit, flowers, and water be given to him. You would save from all the trouble, sitting at home without any work, and all businesses are collapsing. I will accept. Krishna said, I'll accept. We see here Krishna is saying, I'll accept. Somebody asked Srila Prabhupada this question, that when you do offering to the Lord, how do you know Krishna accepts it? So Prabhupada gave a very witty answer. He says in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Asnami, I'll accept it if I offer. So Krishna is saying, is he a liar? Is Krishna a liar? Now, somebody says he doesn't accept. Whom should I accept? Should I accept the words of the Supreme Lord who said, I'll accept it? Or a loafer like you who says, I will not accept it? He really slapped him with a strong word. Whom should I accept? You are saying he doesn't accept. Krishna says, I accept. Whom do I believe? I better believe Krishna than an idiot like you who says he doesn't accept. Correct? But actually, it is true. It is difficult to understand because he keeps the food in front of the Lord and he pick it up, and it looks same. Correct? Yes, but Krishna says, I accept it. Huh?
Yes, true. But the beyond imagination. The prasadam taste.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Visheshyate. Thank you, Naveen, for joining us. Thank you. Take care.
So, just one question to ask Prabhu.
Thank you.
Just one.
Yeah. Hare Krishna, Naveen. Thank you. Yeah, now you wanted to say bye? Yes, okay. Yeah. Yeah, Mataji. Yeah.
Yes. See, we offer food to the pictures of the Lord only. If, no, it's a person who doesn't have deity. It has the same effect. What about the offer? I offer it to Panchatattva photos. Is that also okay, Prabhu?
See, there is no difference. The difference is deities in temples, particularly not at home. The temples, the deities, they are served with love and publicly being worshipped. Correct? See, Lord is present with how much love you approach him. To that degree, his presence will be there. Okay? You understand? The Lord is present in a temple, particularly when the pranapratisthapana is done. He's present, whether you look at him with devotion or not, he's present. But when, as far as the pictures are concerned, it all depends at that moment on your love. Just like we don't put our legs towards the deities in any condition. Correct? Pictures are all around your house 360 degrees. You cannot avoid that. Isn't it? Okay? So deities means it is present with devotion or no devotion. Therefore, suppose in the temple somebody is sitting and spreads his legs towards the Lord, we immediately stop it. Correct? Be careful. Isn't it, Mataji? Hana.
Okay.
But pictures, we are not so strict, you know. It's okay. It depends on his devotion, you know. But deities are present. Your devotion, not devotion, is present. So therefore, deities have to be taken special care. We do public worship of the Lord, then we should do, you know, we should all do so many offerings in a day and all. There is binding. In a picture, there's not binding. Therefore, it is generally intelligent for grihasthas not to bring deities at home because they cannot worship. Correct?
Yes,
should rather focus on the pictures. Generally, people excited bring tikka, but you know, at home they do. But tikka, that kind of one kind of worship go on, but they cannot offer worship properly. Anna?
Yes. So, Panchatattva photo is also equally good,
yeah,
isn't it?
Panchatattva is most merciful. Most yes. merciful. Yeah.
Okay.
So, it's good to worship Panchatattva actually, best.
And for the food to the Panchatattva photo only?
Yes, yes. I remember when I came to Bangalore, I made some 200, 300 frames of Panchatattva. Remember? Big quantity made. Maybe still it may be there. You know? In the yoga kit we had made. People like kids. Okay. Vegetable grain food will be water and papa. Huh?
Thank you for that important point, Prabhu, because I have pictures of Krishna and Prabhupada everywhere, like
altar.
I was also thinking of buying a devotee, getting the devotees.
Deities.
Deities.
Deities require seva, and you should be in a position to serve. Generally, alone and all, avoid it. When there is a full family, then it's, you know, possible. Husband is there, wife is there, children are there. There are four or five people around.
Then you can do. And in the beginning, if you get Gaunitai. Gaunitai, don't hesitate. You can get. But then see that you do some seva regularly. You know, don't keep them unbathed at least. You know, some people, once in a month, they bathe the deities. Don't do all that. If you're getting deities, you know, you cannot live without a bathing. You also have to bathe them. Okay? Is it?
Yes, Prabhu.
Gaunitai, when you come to the platform, first get Gaunitai because offenses are not there. Gaunitai, don't take an office. Okay?
Prabhuji, that Bal Gopal we can keep, Prabhuji?
Bal Gopal is Mataji, not our Gaudiya Vaishnava. That is Pushti Marga.
Okay.
Now I see many ISKCON people have Laddu Gopal with them. It's not recommended. That is
many
Pushti. It is Pushti Marga. It is Vallabhacharya. They are focused on his worship, correct? ISKCON, we worship Gaunitai, Jagannatha in the beginning, then we worship Radha Krishna. That's ISKCON standard, correct? But because, you know, Gujarati is a very powerful, popular. So when you go to Vrindavan, you see Laddu Gopal, people get it.
Yes,
and house, okay, there will be so many, not one. Take in house, what happens is different generally. It's not, if you want to be strict, if we have the deity worship department, they will say, no, just keep picture. Take, even temples, you know, and we have to follow many temples. I know they just keep pictures on. Temples of ISKCON, they don't allow, they're very strict. Because we are having public worship, we have to follow all the standards. And the deities, uninstalled deities are generally not worshipped, correct? But at home, okay, you know, you go from the market and just keep it. That kind of standard is followed at home. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
You take the deities, you do Rathyatra of the deities, you do everything for the deities and don't follow, offer worship to the standards. Horrible, no? In a temple. It's a public worship is going on. In a temple, a visitor comes, a devotion, no devotion, is should be blessed by the presence of the Lord. That's a temple, correct? The Lord has to be invited there. So we have to behave as if the Lord is here. Then how can you say the Lord is here? You don't bathe him. You don't dress him. You do it just once in a week. Correct? You cannot follow that standard. You understand? So in a temple, particularly where public worship is being done, the deities have to be given very high standard of seva. Okay? Mataji, this, why? At home, it's okay, Mataji. It's there. It's fine. But you're not doing a public worship. No, you're not calling all thousands of visitors on your colony to come and take the darshan. Is it? Correct? It's a private worship. That's all goes on in private worship. Many people have so many things they have. I've seen they have Radha Krishna also. They have Radha Krishna, and once a month when they get time, they dress the deity once a month. It's all goes on. The same dress is lying for once a month. Every day we are changing clothes 3 times in a day. Deity is having for once a month. That all happens in house, but it's all okay, Mataji. Take care. But we should advance to the real platform is. Come to the standard when we, you know, many people in the house are trained and deity worship is gradually developed.
See, that's the reason I'm not keeping any deities at home, Prabhu, because we are traveling.
So, Sushmita Mataji, don't worry. At home, it's all fine. You're not doing public worship. It's all fine. Take care.
Okay.
Yes, Arvind Angri Prabhu. Yeah. In fact, happened in proper time, the devotees heard about deities and then they. They're rich in America. They started money to India to get big deities for them. Prabhupada said, stop it. Prabhupada said, as for don't try to imitate the Indians. He gave a certificate to the Indians. They have been trained from centuries. They know how to take care of the deities. Imagine Americans just knew what they know how to take care of the deity at that time. Please, hold on. They have a training. At home, at least, they have some idea. In America, situation, which they don't know which hand to take charna. So where they, you know, they want to get deities and, you know, Prabhupada said, just wait. They have been culturally trained. Even in the house they have, they will offer some respect only to the deities. Right? This cultural training is there to take care of the deities. So that is fine. Yes, it's okay. Arvind Nangi, Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu. Prabhu, we had, I just want to make one point. We had this great Jannivas Prabhu from Mayapur last year here in Bahrain.
Yeah.
And it was regarding the house worship. The one thing he mentioned, if you are worshipping the house, you have to set a standard and maintain that standard. Don't go beyond it.
Yeah, that's. But still, what happened? There are many aspects of this. Whenever I came recently, I came to Oman. I saw so wonderfully. Everybody had kept the main room in the house for the Jagannath Baldev Subhadra, correct? Because there, the preaching in the Gulf is you cannot have temples, correct? So people have converted their houses into temples, isn't it? And amazing thing was that beautiful Jagannath Baldev Subhadra and beautiful altar. Amazing. They got some Bengalis to make, and that I saw in Salala, and beautiful altars they're having. Much better than we have. Beautiful altar. I took photographs also. Amazing. And main room in the house is for the deity. And they're all four or five people in the house, you know, shuffled in a small room, because when there is a guest, like I was a guest in some houses, that time they give you that room, you know. All family members are stuck in one room. But I was seeing so impressive. Practically all the houses who are preaching, correct? Main room they have given to the deities, isn't it?
Yeah.
Correct? And definitely they cannot offer standard of worship that happens in the temple. But still, some good standard, because mostly all are working. So morning they do some seva and evening they come back and they do some seva. But happened Jagannath Baldev Subhadra and Gaunitai were the right choice they have done, because there are no offenses involved. Both are very merciful for Kali Yuga, correct? But if you have Radha Krishna and all, then you know we should be careful.
Yes.
Take care. In a ISKCON temple, if you have Radha Krishna, they will insist that 6 Brahmin initiated devotees should be there minimum. They'll insist in the temple. And the sevas will be from, you cannot have without Rajboga. You have to have Rajboga. You have to have this seva. You have to have that seva. Lot of sevas will be involved. Correct? That is the point. Okay. So house worship and deity worship in a temple is different standards. Correct? Temple, the deities are in a public worship. Correct? And they're going for festivals. You have Rath Yatra. You have so many festivals. Janmashtami, you're taking the deities and all. So therefore, the deity should be present. Person looks at devotion and not devotion. You got the point? There is a difference. So just like a picture is there, you look without devotion, it's fine. But the deities are there. Somebody comes and sits there in front of the Lord. Devotion, not devotion, Lord blesses him because he's present there. Okay? So when you have invoked the presence of the Lord in a temple where there is public worship going on, the worship of the Lord also should be of the same standard. You know, you're saying the Lord is present. In a picture, Lord is present. When you look at devotion, when you don't look at devotion, he's not present. Okay? You understand the point. Correct? But in the deity, the Lord is present. You look at devotion, not look at devotion. So when the public worship is happening in the temple, so we definitely want when people come, they get blessed by the Lord. Isn't it? Correct? They sit in front of the deity. The devotion, not devotion, Lord is present. He's looking at you. You want him to look, the Lord to look at the every visitor. Correct? People look or not, Lord should look. Then you assume that the Lord is present there. Therefore, the seva standard should be the same when the Lord is present. Correct? Therefore, the standard of worship in a public worship in the temple has to be very high to the standard given in the Pancharatrika Vidhi. And in the house, when you're having deities or pictures, that's a different thing altogether. But preferable, if you ask Pancharatra people, they will say better have pictures. Avoid having the deities. If you have Gaunitai Jagannatha, because they don't take any office. And this point also very clear, correct what is Jananivas Prabhu said. He is actually one of the authorities of Pancharatra and ISKCON, correct, worshipping Mayapur 50 years, more than 50 years. And they look so saintly, both the brothers, so saintly.
Right.
In Mayapur, everybody goes, everybody notices them so well, so calm, they're so calm. So anyway, so he said, whatever standard is set, you have to follow the standard. Don't come down. You keep going up. You never come down, correct? Isn't it? Deity worship, whatever standard is it, keep going up, not keep going down. Okay, so this is done. Thank you very much. Bhavagrahi, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. Aap to Jagannath sevak hain, koi problem nahi. Jagannath to aparadh lete hi nahi. Yes. He is a Kaluga deity. Hana, Baba?
Yes, Prabhu.
Doesn't take any
of that. Very merciful.
Very merciful, yes. Yes, Bhumika ji, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yes, Hare Krishna. So only 4 kind of things you can eat. Patra, Pushpa, Phala and Toya. Theek hai?
Yes, Prabhu.
Theek hai. Nishant, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Dhanwad, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Pushpa Mata ji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna, Arvind Angir, Prabhu.
Thank you.
Theek hai. Hare Krishna, Himali. Hare Krishna, Rupa Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yes. Mata Kalpataru Vrasya Kripa Sindhu Vevacha Patitanam Pavinevyo Vaishnava Namo. Arat Kodi Vaishnava Vindiki.
Jai.
Sopat Ki.
Jai.
Hare Krishna.